Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I received this little box here in the mail. Look how pretty it is. Just gotta give the packaging just a minute there. And when I opened it, I saw that I had not only the BH Cosmetics Take Me Back to Brazil palette, but their new Take Me Back to Brazil Rio Edition palette in there. I showed you guys on Instagram, would you guys want to see a video on this and everything else that's in the box? You said yes, so that is what I am doing in this video. And because I just want to get into it, let's just get right into the video. So I don't normally start videos out with one eye already done, but if you are not new to my channel, then you already know how I feel about the BH Cosmetics Take Me Back to Brazil palette. So this is the one that I already owned. I've done a video, I will leave it here or in the description so you can see my initial thoughts on this palette. Now there is a new one in that PR box, and I was thinking, should I just do this video with the one that I already own so that I can give that one away, or should I use that one and see if there's any differences? But I decided to just use the one that I already had, and I will give away the one that is untouched in the box. So this is what the Take Me Back to Brazil palette looks like. As you can see, a very colorful palette, and if you know me, you would think this is right up my alley, unless you've seen the video that I've done on this palette. Like, I bring it up close. Wait, all right, let me try to get my face out of the way so that it'll focus on the palette. If you're up close and personal with this palette, you'll see that I really have to dig into, you'll see I really have to dig into the colors to get pigments, to get anything to show up on my eyes. One of the reasons why I am just using a straight up white base today, because the pigment wasn't that there when I did my initial video on this. Now, I did use this quite a few times after I first reviewed it, especially in my Halloween tutorials, because paired with other things, then you get a little better color payoff there. But especially with this color and this red here, you can see I really dug into those. So this, let me show you the outside first here, is the Take Me Back to Brazil Rio Edition palette, and that is what the inside of this one looks like. I'm trying to be really careful with this one because when I opened the PR package, this shade right here was shattered and it got all over the entire palette, so I'm trying not to have it spill everywhere. But as you can probably tell, it's literally the same exact as the Take Me Back to Brazil, except this is all shimmers. All of these shades are shimmers, where in this one a lot of them are matte, but there are some shimmers in this one as well. And also in the PR package were these glitters that they're also coming out with, so I wanted to figure out a way to use everything that was in there, and I came up with, well, this eye look right here. So let's just go ahead so I can tell you some more things about these palettes and this glitter. Okay, so funny thing, my inspo for this eye look is this little section here of the palette. I don't know why, but I'm thinking, you know, taking back to Brazil, Rio, if you see the way that they've been promoting this collection and the launch party that they had, is giving me carnival type vibes. So that's what this eye look and this neon top is going for. So my inspo was this corner right here. So I'm going to start out with this blue right here. So because this palette, and I know these shades are the way that they are, first I just go in with a layer of whatever color I'm using and just kind of stamp it on to where I want that color to be. Yes, even on a white base, that's how much original color payoff I get with this. And then with another layer of product, I just start doing little circle blending motions, and I do this until I get enough layers of color that's actually going to show up on my face. I think I had to do 3 layers of each color that you see on this side of my eye, so yeah, this is gonna take a minute. Okay, so with that same brush, this is the Anastasia 825, I'm gonna take this blue shade right next to the one that we just used. And again, first just put the color where I want it, and we're gonna go a little over the first blue, and then we go in with little circle motions. Okay, and then same brush, we're gonna take this blue right here and stamp, stamp, stamp. Like, I feel like this one really just shows you what we're working with here. This is a dark blue, and with stamping it on, this is how it's appearing on my eye.
Let's try blending that out.
Okay, so I went ahead and cut my crease. Now we're gonna take this green from the Rio palette and start using that on my lid.
Okay, and I'm just going to pat that in.
Okay, so then we're gonna take the blue that correlates with the second blue that we used in, oh, I'm just spilling everywhere, from the matte palette. Can you see this? So this blue right here. And we're just going to stamp that on a little over the green, and they blend into each other really nicely. Like, you don't even have to do that much blending between the two to get them to blend. And oh, did I block everything? My bad. And again, just pat it on.
So now we're going to switch back over to this palette and take this purple right here and use that in my outer corner
and just start applying it there. This isn't the brush that I need. I need something that's round like this, but something a little bit denser. This is still too fluffy, but it's what I have right now. So we're gonna make it work because I am too lazy to go find the one that does work. Don't judge me. Then take some of that darkest blue that we used and put it right over the purple. So switch back over to the Rio palette and take the shimmer that correlates with the darker blue that we just used, so this one right here, and then just blend that blue and that purple together. Okay, so now I'm just taking some of the NYX glitter glue and going along the line that I cut my crease at so I can put the glitter down. And I'm trying to get more glue up here. Let me see if you can see that. I'm trying to get more glue up here than I do down here so that, you know, you can see I kind of tried to do that over here so that it's less down here and more up there. So this is the glitter that I'm using. It is the BH Glitter Collection Loose Glitter in the shade Mermaid Mood. And let me put some, and then just push the glitter wherever you placed the glue. Okay, so that is it for my eyes for right now. I'm gonna go ahead and finish my face. I'm thinking liner, but I'm also thinking don't do it. So I might come back with that on, I might not, but I'm gonna come back and tell you my thoughts on all these products from BH. Alrighty then, so that is it for this look. I didn't do liner. Not sure if that was a good idea or not, but what I did do is use the new Too Faced concealer. Again, this is my second time using this, and I just feel like I'm giving orange in this area of my face, like wherever I would put concealer. Let me know if that's just me in the comments down below, but yeah, that is it for this look. Now for my thoughts on the products that I tried. So first I have the glitter that I used. I think there are six that are coming out with this collection, six or eight. I used this pink one right here. This was a really nice glitter. It's not chunky or anything like that. The only thing is it took a little bit of work, I guess is how I should put it, to get it to stick to the adhesive, but I'm not sure if that's the adhesive's fault or if that's the glitter's fault. Now for the new Take Me Back to Brazil Rio Edition palette, I actually really like this. I feel like they went a little all out on the packaging here. It's legit like glitter on the outside, and then once you open it up, again, because I have that one shade that shattered there, we're gonna be careful with how we hold this. Like I said, these are all shimmers in this palette, and these are like a buttery type of shimmer, and those are usually the best kind that you can use. I have a all shimmer palette from BH that came out a while ago, and it's not the same, like they're not the same type of feel. Like you can literally feel your brush melting into these shimmers. I would try to do like a swatch or two here, but yeah, I don't think my nails are fitting into those pans. Yeah, I was trying to get some, and then my nail just got stuck right in one of the pans. So here is one color, two colors, and then this is the one that got caught in the other pan, so I didn't get that much on my finger, but there are some quick swatches there. And for some reason, if I was doing an all shimmer,
eyeshadow look, I really don't even feel like you would need a white base to go with these. Actually, no, I didn't use the white base when I cut my crease that I used for the matte shadow. So this isn't the shimmer shades on my eyes. They're not on top of a white base and they're still pretty pigmented. I don't feel like you would need white for them to show up like the matte palette. So if for some reason, if you were in need of an all shimmer palette, you know, maybe you're a makeup artist or maybe you just have an all matte palette and you want shimmers to go along with those mattes and you want colorful shimmers, I do feel like this is a really nice palette. I feel some kind of way that one of the shades broke and got all over all the other shades, but you know, I'll get over it. And once again, I have used the Take Me Back to Brazil palette and my feelings are still the same. I feel like this is a palette that as colorful as it is and as pigmented as you think it should be, it just isn't. I feel like you have to really put the efforts into this type of palette when using it so you can actually get some color payoff. Even with a white base, some of those shades were a tad bit of a struggle. Like I said, I have still used it after that first review. I think it does well with other shades. You know, it blends in really nicely with other colorful shadows. I'm certainly going to use it again this year for my Halloween videos. I just think you need to know going into it that it's going to take some, you know, some elbow grease to really get some color payoff with this one. But it is an affordable option. I just feel like if this was a little bit more pigmented, this would be like top fave colorful palettes out there. And that is it for this video. I feel like I really look orange in the center of my face, but anyway, so I hope seeing me try these products out on my face and hearing some of my thoughts has helped. If you're thinking of checking any of these products out for yourself, make sure to thumbs up, comment, and subscribe down below. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. We'll be right back.